she has done an MA entrance in Jainology from the Department of Jainology, University of Madras, and currently she's also a guest faculty over there. And she's a very good singer, okay? You'll be listening to her in your IDP session. And her topic is the spiritual horizon. Bhakti is a journey that all the theories are left behind, and what remains is mere experience. It is which, when all the doubts are dispelled, and what remains is mere divinity. Jai Janindra, good afternoon, and welcome to one and all present here. I am Kajal Jain, and I am going to take you to witness the beauty of spiritual horizon. Now, what is horizon? Horizon. There's a belief that the sky and the earth do not meet each other, but there's also faith that they meet each other at the point of horizon. We call it as the horizon point. Yes. Shittaj, yes, exactly. So that is where the impossible seems possible, and it becomes practically impossible to trace out the difference between the sky and the earth. Similarly, the Bhakt and Bhagwan. The Bhakt and Bhagwan are apart and two different identities, but they can be one at the peak of devotion, at the peak of bhakti. So the phenomenon where the Bhakt and Bhagwan no more remain apart or do not appear to be two different identities is the spiritual horizon. And this union of Bhakt and Bhagwan leaves behind no difference and no distance between the two. Now, one such beautiful composition which erases this difference of Bhakt and Bhagwan is BHAKTAMARA STOTRA. And this is why we have been gathered here for 2 days. We have been listening from all the speakers about BHAKTAMARA STOTRA, so I will not go into it too much. But in this paper, I am going to compare the works of a great legend, Srimad Rajchandra, who is a divinity personified, his works, and relating the verses of BHAKTAMARA STOTRA. So BHAKTAMARA STOTRA is a gem of Jain devotional literature, and the shackles or the prison in which Mantumata, it is believed that Acharya Shri ko video se bandha gaya tha. But in reality, when I see the picture of Acharya Mantu, I feel that it is not Acharya Mantu, it is you and I who are behind. Hum log is sansar se jabde hue hai, aur isse nikalne ke liye bhakti ek bahut hi adbhut sadhan hai. तो इट इज नॉट आचार्य मानतो, ये हमारी और आपकी कथा है. भक्तामर सूत्र कोई और नहीं है. हम लोगों को संसार से छूटने के लिए एक भक्ति का साधन है. सो दिस इज द ट्रू भक्ति विच आचार्य मानतो है डिस्क्राइब इन भक्तामर सूत्र प्रेजिंग लॉर्ड आदिनाथ. नाउ इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. यहाँ पर दो ज्ञानियों के पिक्चर आप देख सकते हैं. वन इज आचार्य मानतो एंड अदर इज श्रीमद राजचंद्र. पहले जो है वो करीबन हजार साल पहले हुए थे, और ये जो है ये 150 साल पहले ही हुए थे. तो आई थिंक यू ऑल कैन कनेक्ट विद हिम, बिकॉज इन दिस कलिकाल ही टॉट द पाथ ऑफ लिबरेशन थ्रू भक्ति, श्रीमद राजचंद्र. सो and it is rightly said Srimad Rajchandra was called as Kripaludev by his followers, because he was an embodiment of compassion. And to prove the points here, I just like to quote Kripaludev. He said, agar jnani thai gaya vartman ma hoy thashi kal bhavishya ma marg bhed nahi koi. So agar bhagav there had been enlightened persons in the past, there are at present, and there will be in the future. But there is no difference in the path. Yes? So, next slide. Srimad Rajchandra is a divinity personified, and he was an embodiment of divinity, ideal of human pursuit. His life is a convergence of discrimination, devotion, and detachment. 3 Ds. ज्ञान, भक्ति और वैराग्य. ज्ञान यानी discrimination, bhakti yani devotion and detachment, that is vairagya. In tino ka bejor sangam unki jeevan katha mein aap dekh sakte hain aur in tino ke bejor sangam se hi aap moksh ki taraf prayan kar sakte hain. Next. So I have just briefed about his legendary works in my paper. Simple, precise and yet immensely profound, Kripaludev's literary works are an expression of his supreme inner state. Laying down a clear and complete path to spiritual living, one read is enough to answer the existential questions. By every next reading takes you deeper until neither the questioner nor the question remains. This was the beauty of his works. And he was a born poet, started his literary work at the age of 8. His poetic talent, power of rapid composition, high degree of imagination, coupled with intuitive reasoning ability, all abided in him since childhood. In virtue of these qualities, he was awarded as a title of Sakshat Saraswati. And he used to perform Shatavdhan. What is Shatavdhan? Performing 100 tasks at a time. He wrote books like Sri Niti Bodhak, Mokshmala, Bhavna Bodh, and you will find most of his literature, in fact 95% of his literature is in form of letters written to his devotees and disciples. And in addition to these, he composed Atma Siddhi Shastra, whose verses I'll be taking in the paper. Well, it was an immortal work. The next work is Apurva Avsar, which is also again a masterpiece describing the development of a soul in 14 Mulasthans. And then Shri Sadguru Bhakti Rasya Mool Mar Kevalya Vichu Bina Nayan Ichche Chete Joginayan and other poems. So this was the works of Srimad Rajchandra. And mainly the essence of his teachings were, his life was completely immersed in seva, satsang, sadhana, and he attained sannyasa at the age of 23. And all his works contain, he always emphasized on having a Sajivan Murti, Sadguru. So since we are talking about Bhaktamar is also about a Guru and a Shishya, that is Bhagwan and the Bhakt. Similarly, so he has also expressed this same feeling, same emotion in his all the texts. Now, before we venture into the pages of devotion, let us discard all the bias and prejudices. Before we swim into the ocean of devotion, let us hold with us nothing else but humility, modesty and a pure heart combined with deep craving for knowledge. Let us carry in our minds the yearning for the secret of liberation. Now let us compare the works of Mantung Acharya and Srimad Rajchandra. Now, in the first data of Bhaktamara Stotra, as we have all discussed the meaning, I will not go deep into it. Jaise Indra Devta Padarmatma ko naman karte hain, to devtaon ke jo mukut hote hain, mukut mein jo mani hai, unki shobha yani the shine, wo aur bhi zyada bright ho jate hain. Kisi wajah se? Paramatma ke nakun ki urja se. Yani jo dev, iska adhyatmik meaning is tarah hai, ki jo dev Paramatma ko naman karta hai, उस जीव के पाप ऐसे ही नाश हो जाते हैं. मतलब द आत्मा ग्लोरीफाइड एंड सारे पाप ऐसे ही विलीन हो जाते हैं. उसी प्रकार इसी बात को दर्शाते हुए कृपालु देव ने अपनी आत्मसिद्धि शास्त्र में कहा, मानादि क्षत्रु महान निधि छंदे न मराए, जाता सदगुरु शरण मां अल्प प्रयास ही जाए. यानी मान आदि शत्रु यानी जो चार दशा है, राग द्वेष मोह ईर्ष्या इत्यादि जो भी डिफाइनमेंट्स है, वो सारे खुद से अगर आप निकालना चाहो तो नहीं जाएंगे, पर सतगुरु की शरण में जाने से अल्प प्रयास यानी विद लेस एफर्ट्स और नो एफर्ट्स, ये है भक्ति की पराकाष्ठा, ये है मैजिक ऑफ भक्ति. सो सेम थ्रेड यू विल फाइंड द नेक्स्ट डाटा, प्रत्येक सदगुरु योग थी स्वचंद तेर होता है, अन्य उपाय करिया तति प्राय वमनो थाय. तो इसे प्रत्येक सदगुरु के योग से स्वचंद यानी अपनी स्वेच्छा अनुसार धर्म के साधन करना, तो वो अगर आप चाहते हो कि आपका स्वचंद रुक जाए तो वो नहीं जाने वाला है, पर सदगुरु के योग से चला जाएगा। और अगर आप खुद से करने चाहोगे तो ट्राई बंगलो था, बंगलो मीन्स डबल, सो इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू रिमूव देम इट विल गेट डबल। सो आई होप द मीनिंग इज क्लियर। दिस इज द फ्रूट ऑफ द ग्रेस ऑफ भक्ति विच विल हेल्प यू टू ओवरकम द वाइसेस इन यू एंड मेक यू मोर डिवाइन। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। So in this, I have compared the three verses of Bhaktamara Stotra, that is 3rd, 4th and 5th. Balam Vihaya Jalasansita Mindu Bimba. I think all the comparisons have been done by all the speakers. Still, Kaste Shamata, the example of an ignorant child trying to see the moon in the pond. And then Kaste Shamata Guru Prati Mokta Vidya. Yani ki, jo Brihaspati hai, jo देवताओं के गुरु है, वो भी आपकी इतने इतना दिन के पास ज्ञान है, वो भी आपकी भक्ति करने में असमर्थ है, तो मैं क्या चीज होंगे सामने। एंड देन द थर्ड वन, नागरिक की अपने शिशु को बचाने के लिए खड़ी हुई एक शेर का भी सामना करती है। उसी प्रकार इन ऑल द थ्री आर्टर्स इट इज एक्सप्लेन दैट इट इज इम्पॉसिबल, ये टास्क जो है इम्पॉसिबल है, फिर भी आपके प्रति भक्ति आ रही है तो मैं कर रहा हूँ, आपकी स्तुति कर रहा हूँ, इसी बात को दर्शाते हैं। यहाँ परमात्मा की स्तुति है, उसी प्रकार अपूर्व अवसर में एक गाता है। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। जे पद श्री सर्वज्ञ दीठ ज्ञान माँ कई शक्या नहीं पन ते श्री भगवान जो तेह स्वरूप ने अन्य वाणी ते शू कहे। किस स्वरूप की बात कर रहे हैं? अपने शुद्धात्म स्वरूप की बात। उसी प्रकार भक्तामर में अपने आत्म स्वरूप को it can only be experience, expression ki baat, it cannot be, matlab words fall short for that, the vocabulary falls short. So is anya swarup, us swarup ko anya vani, yani jab brihaspati bhi nahi kar paaye to main, matlab meri vani se main kaise kar paunga? To waise hi shivan raja ji kehte hai ki teh swarup ne anya vani te chu kahe anubhav gochar matra rahi te gyan jo. It is a matter of experience and not एक्सपीरियंस। And that is the bridge. वो bridge को तोड़ने की ताकत